While we're on the subject of supplements, let's lob you this is a question I get all the time, and that is two things about diet. First one is there a strong link between eating dairy products and prostate cancer?
Well, first of all, I don't know if you could hear the barking in the back. My dog's trying to get in. So I was looking at you in the eyes, but I was turning away to send a note to my wife. I wrote, please help Chauncey. So hopefully she's gonna figure out in the next few minutes that he's trying to get in here. Because I think he wants, I think you know how much
Mark,
your dog likes you.
We have nothing against dogs. You can allow the dog in.
I know, but the dog will take over. And, you know, we're egomaniacs. We don't want to share the spotlight. So we're narcissistic. Anyway,
all right.
So I am not a fan of somebody stopping dairy strictly because they think that a glass of milk or a piece of cheese is going to stimulate tumor growth. What people need to understand about the dairy studies is they were epidemiological, which means they were observational. Mm-hmm. And there is a fact of life around the world, including the United States, that in certain populations, when you study them, the people that eat the most dairy and eat the most meat also tend to have a lot of other lifestyle behaviors that aren't necessarily favorable or healthy. Mm. So to simply grab dairy as the enemy, I wish it was that simple. But the reality is it's a reflection of overall behavior. It's just like sometimes when you study smokers, you go, oh, they're smokers, they're bad. But the average smoker tends to drink too much, tends to be physically inactive, tends to have a poor diet. So I know they want to tease out dairy. I just don't like the idea, and I don't know how you feel in oncology. I don't like the idea of telling someone that they have to 100% eliminate one of the joys of their life if that's what they want once in a while, because that's going to make or break their prostate cancer. My personal belief is that if all you did was cut out dairy and it would make or break your prostate cancer, Mark Scholz would never have a job. If cancer was that simple, there's no way you would have a job. No, I'm being serious. And so
I agree.
And so I believe there's what I call deference to cancer. Deference to cancer is the longer I've been out there, I have realized after 33 years that it is a far complex, heterogeneous disease. And so here's what I would say, Dr. Scholz. If you like to consume dairy, what does that mean for your general health? Are you gaining weight on it? Some of the dairies are very high in sugars. So like look at some of the milks.
Well, sugar and fat.
Sugar and fat. But the reality is if it's causing you to gain weight, if it's causing cholesterol changes, if it's causing what I call a general unhealthy momentum shift, then it is time to cut back on it.
Can I tell you something, Dr. Moyad? I love your answer. It's the truth rather than a simplistic one. And therefore, I think it's almost useless. It seems like the average human, I'm going to insult our audience now.
Oh my gosh.
I know I'm not supposed to
give your address when you're done.
It is this whole global concept. You shared this at the conference, I think the conference before last, that the pathway to weight loss may not matter. It's
right.
What you eat. It's where do you end up?
That's
are you
right.
carrying around a big roll of fat around your middle? And almost anything you do to get rid of that is going to benefit you.
That's right.
So so I think that's an excellent answer. For a simplistic person like myself,
yeah.
I say, okay, let's cut out the meat. Let's cut out the but what I tell my patients is say, consider your meats more like condiments rather than staples. Enjoy them, but don't build a whole life around them.
That's right. They should be basically a once in a while hobby. They should not be what you're doing day in and day out. But the reality is I have a saying for this Q&A. This will be my one saying. I try to throw in one saying and I thought, what's going to be the saying when it comes to diet? It is you can talk quality in your diet all day long, but unless it affects the quantity of something, then what's the point? So you can talk quality all day long. But unless it affects the quantity of something, what do I mean by quantity? Well, I mean, your weight, if it's, you can change. And this is what happened in the most recent active surveillance trial, which we had a lot of questions on in diet. If you're not going to change your weight by changing your quality, if you're not going to change your cholesterol, if you're not going to change your blood pressure, if you're not going to change mood, if you're not going to change the staples of health by changing quality, then I'm not so sure you're going to get a tangible outcome. So quality matters. but so does quantity. And I'm not just talking about the quantity of food. Quality should change quantity. It should change the objective numbers that you work with your physician to become more heart healthy.